We are back live on Morning Line. Nick Beres along with Davidson County Sheriff Daron Hall. It's good to have him on. You know, today it was my birthday. I don't know. Someone told him about it. And he brought me something very nice, which is a key to the jail, the old jail. And thank you for that.
Well, you're welcome.
And then we talked about a lot of things. One of the, you know, the sheriff here and his department's involved with giving blood, the last minute toy store, and you're doing it Christmas in July.
Right.
So we're trying to get into the Christmas spirit with you as well. So we have some guests who are coming up now to
What are these guys? What in the world?
Come on up. We have Dale Robbie with us.
Hey, man. How are you doing, Dale? Good to see you, man. You as well. I was bragging about you earlier.
Good to see you again. Mark Binda with Channel 5.
He's the programming director.
Oh, my gosh.
Dr. Binda.
Nick's boss.
Yeah, he's everyone's my boss.
Hello. Great. Well, nice to see you.
But he's, okay, he's president of the Last Minute Toys.
Yes, that's right.
And you two have gotten that partnership together. You're doing the situation. I better stand up.
I'll stand up, I guess.
All right. Sit down.
We'll get straight up.
We're orchestrating all this. You guys have a seat.
I'm not ready for all
anyway,
this.
Anyway, it's Christmas in July, and you know, News Channel 5 wants to be a part of all of this. So, Dr. Binda.
On behalf of the Scripps Howard Foundation, Scripps is the parent company of Channel 5. They're making a donation to the Last Minute Toy Store, so we're presenting you with this check. We're going to use that money to buy classic games. Scripps was really, you know, Scripps has done the spelling bee for years, so I kind of pitched them on the idea, like, we'll buy a bunch of Scrabble games.
Monopoly, and, stuff like
Monopoly,
that.
Monopoly, Risk.
So board games. That's awesome.
Well, thank you from the sheriff's office for sure, and thank you for all the work you do. I was bragging about you a minute ago. I'm a little rattled. I didn't know this was going to happen.
Thank you. $1,250.
And I think you all get board games. We got some.
There we go.
You'll have one as well.
Thank you guys.
Thank you so much for doing this, Scripps, and it means so much to so many people. And on behalf of Alan Smith, who is our treasurer, he works at Nissan corporate, and he could not be here today, but you know, it's such a blessing. And obviously Sheriff Hall,
we can't thank him enough.
You know, in this biz, we do a lot of stories on this. We've been doing stories on this every year, and we see it, and we want to be a part of it. What is it, the number, 5,000 children last year?
Last year, almost 5,500 children.
5,500 children, and again, let's just remind folks why it's important to talk about this even in July, why you need money like this in donations. Right. You were saying how many gifts. These are kids coming from families without the last minute toy story, which is what it says it is, may not have anything under the tree.
That is correct. I mean, the last minute toy store runs this year will be December 20th to the 22nd, and we are truly the last chance, the last minute toy store for children who've missed the other charity deadline. So if they miss the Angel Tree deadline or some other charities in town, then they come to us. And last year we had, as sheriff remembers, 5,500 children show up in those families, and it was overwhelming. This year it could be far more. So having enough inventory, supply, gifts.
The last thing you want to do is run out.
And the last thing we want to do is be the last minute toy store runs out of gifts. That's
for sure. Don't turn anyone away. But last year I remember, because that was the first time with the where. Yes. Did you guys bust some out? Or, you know, people would come out. Just remind folks where this was at and how that worked last year for the first time.
Yeah, so I met Dale through a mutual friend, a couple of years ago, and we sat in a room and had lunch, and I won't ever forget, I was saying, you know, we're really interested in trying to help find something, and he was interested in finding a location, and we were trying to find something to invest our energy in, and it was just divine intervention, I believe that, and we look up, and all of a sudden, I said, well, let's go look at this warehouse space that we have, because I didn't know exactly what they needed. It turned out to be, with a lot of work that they put into it, our staff, really a fantastic setup for the operation. And really, from a person who had heard of it and been a part of it from a distance, never really volunteered or been directly involved, I sat there and watched, and the very first day, the family member comes out and they're issued a ticket to come back and do their shopping. Mm-hmm. One of the things that would blow your mind, this is a warehouse, basically. Mm-hmm. Once you receive your ticket, the family member, in this case, it was a woman, she was walking out to go to her car, I guess, to go home and come back and shop at her time. Once she gets her ticket, and then she's allowed to walk through this, what is really like a store. And you just saw tears flowing down this woman's face. And I just, it was worth every bit of anything. And so thank you for anything, and thank our staff. I think we've given $12,000 from our staff alone. And I was last week, I saw a guy in his casual clothing, and what that really means to us is that they've given $20 this month to Last Minute Toys to allow them to do that. So just a great effort. Nashville is a great place, but there are people who need this. And
my question is, will kids play the classic board games? Well, okay, I'm trying to think of all of them. All right, yeah, the ones we know, and we're going to say it, and if anyone's watching, or what?
Clue.
Masterpiece. Clue. Risk, which was a great game.
Right.
Risk.
I'm the only person who remembers Masterpiece.
I love Masterpiece. Get by the Rembrandt. All of them. Monopoly, of course, everyone knows about. But the idea is, well, whatever you guys, I suppose, need it for. Right. But the
That's
classic
awesome.
Board games.
That is fantastic.
Vicki Yates introduced me to the toy store about 4 years ago, and it just touched my heart. So I've been doing it every year since.
Yeah.
I think I made the Hall of Fame last year. One of the women, my son Jake and I were escorting through the toy store, actually went into labor while we were
there. My God.
She was dedicated. She was getting those toys for her kid.
Well, you see so many things. I remember last year right in the middle of this, and that this is just where we are in Nashville, and is, you know, we needed interpreters. There's a lot of people. And so just to make sure, so we were rounding up people and friends, can you get in touch? And just having anything, you just never really, and the weather, I mean, you're dealing with a lot of different things, and parking. I mean, I look up, it looked like Harding Place was in our side. So that was a good thing. It was, they do great. It's a fantastic organization, and I'm just really happy that we can, as a sheriff's office, kind of find a way to year-round give back, and it was what we were looking for, and the marriage feels fantastic to us, so I'm really happy about
it. And we're glad Scripps could do this.
That's
a
fantastic.
Neat thing, and we'll continue
thank
to promote
it. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thanks for coming on.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Mark,
thank
for
you.
Everything you
thank
did.
You,
Mark,
us
thank
happen.
You, too, for surprising the guys.
Well, it was your birthday.
Here.
I was hoping we were going to
see.
What are we doing?
He was hoping for cake.
I was going to share the birthday.
Gentlemen, thank you for coming on. Best of luck with everything. Make sure to let us know when there's anything we can promote to get word out on more fundraising and all
that. Thank you so much.
We'll take a break. Come back. I'll wrap things up with a good sheriff right after this. Stay with us. This